this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll begin with a handoff to Smith. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
He's tackled at the 34.
It's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45.
He was despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
Hey, Tuesday, Tuesday, Tuesday.
Here's Ryan to throw. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 38-yard line. 2 catches in the first half. Now he's got a 3rd here, and it's good for a first. Now Ryan on first down. And Jones has it over the middle. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. That one goes for 24 yards.
First down, Falcons.
From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
8 yards on the pickup.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seahawks, 6-yard line.
On second down, it's Smith, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half, 4 down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready.
No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line.
2-yard line.
Here's Ryan. And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown.
Touchdown, Atlanta.
2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Falcons draw a bit closer. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the 3rd quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off. And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Pretty important 3rd quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
46 to Mike. Let's go double count right here. Double count. Kill, kill, kill. Turn it up. Good side. Kill, turn it up.
SOS, SOS, SOS. SOS.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
It's now second and
I like the thought process there. They connected out a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Hey, check Mike 46. Check Mike 46. Hey, check.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Flush to his right. He's going to take off with it. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point. That's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game. I guess he picked a good time to do it.
He certainly did. Not only did he have the element of surprise, he's making sure he's judicious in taking off.
Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 36 now, first and 10. He'll find Metcalf, and he's going to be taken down right at the line. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Throwing again on second down. Wilson eluding the pressure right. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And finally down at the 36-yard line. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
So they move from 136 over to the other as they come up on first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
At the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
Second and 10. At the Falcons, 36-yard line.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. From the shotgun, Wilson being chased out left. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. It was Ricardo Allen there on the coverage.
And the end result of that play, you're almost not sure what you really want, because when he gets outside of the pocket, you actually hold your breath because you think he's going to run for big yardage. But when he chose to pull it down and throw it, and a play was made to knock it away, that's a pretty good end result. Not one you expected when the play began.
Another incompletion would certainly be ideal defensively. A big play now. This is third and 10. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On third down, Wilson. open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Big hook up there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up.
Let's go, defense. And here we go.
Watch the air.
Undercrush.
Here's Carson. And the Seahawks are going to have a first and goal forthcoming as he takes this down to about the 5-yard line. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. They run again with Carson. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1.
Stop short of the goal.
Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got it third and goal now as they look for that final touchdown. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Chris Carson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative plays, and that way you're able to run what you have to run when you get a chance to call it.
He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14.
Seahawks 28, Falcons 14. Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. To throw again, Ryan. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 16 yards, a first down.
And the Falcon first down.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Jordan Brooks with it. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for Brooks here, down 2 scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
A pickup of six brings up second and four.
Wilson gonna throw. He lets it fly for Lockett. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by Devontae Kaysen. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
17-yard line.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Here's Ryan. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football.
Calvin Ridley.
The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now Ryan. One incomplete. Intended target on that one, Russell Gage. And now it's second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
He's going to have the hook up to Gage. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout.
Brings up
as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Midfield now. Here's Ryan. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. Benson Mayoa in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Demarius Randle, and that will write a finish to this ball game.